Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about continental drift theory, which was given by Alfred Wegener. He was a German meteorologist. So according to him, whole earth after its formation, it was only one. It means all the land masses were one, whom he has given the name Pangaea, and all water parts were also together, which was named as Penthalassa. Now, near about 200 million years ago, this Pangaea started to split, and it split into two land masses. The upper, the land mass which was at the northern area, it was known as Laurasia, and which was at southern part, it was known as Gondwana. And the gap in between Laurasia and Gondwana, it was filled with water, so he has given the name Tethys Sea. Now, further, we know like plates are moving, like even still now also plates are moving. So because of this movement and all, Laurasia was further divided into Asia, Europe and North America. And Gondwana is also divided into South America, Africa, Australia, Antarctica and India. Okay, so please make sure the time this split was going on, India was not the part of Asia as it is now. Okay, so Asia was in Laurasia and India was in Gondwana. Now, whatever he told Mr. Wegener, he has given some evidences according to his observation. So, first one observation is a matching of continents. So, hope we all had played a jigsaw fit game in which we need to join the parts of different, like if there is a human body, we need to join exactly where should be the hand, where should be the eyes, nose and all. In the same way, he told us, like if we check the shoreline of South America and Africa, it exactly fits there. Okay, so according to him, because this fits exactly here, so it was one of the proof, like whole all the land masses were together first as Pangaea. Second is rocks of same age across the ocean, like we have a process that is known as a radiometric method, by which we could find out the ages of different rocks, even animals, plants, everything. So by that process also, we came to know, like he got ideas, he got evidences, like the rocks which are found in different parts of continent, they were of same age, like they were made or formed at same age. Especially the rocks which are found in this portion, Brazil and area, they were same, like everything, their age, the characteristic, it was same, the rocks which were found at western coast of Africa. So it was one next proof for him, like the rocks which are found in different areas, they were of same age. So it is proved as it is a proof of second evidence. Third, we have trilite. So the trilite means these are the sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks, you know, the rocks which is made by layers and layers and layers. So these are the rocks which are made by deposits of glacier. Okay, hope you all know, whenever any of the external agents, either it is river or the wind or glaciers, when they move, obviously they take sediments with it, and according to their speed, according to the strength of the sediment, the weight of sediment also varies. In the same way, when glacier formed from the beginning or from the mouth, it takes a lot of sediment. Slowly, slowly it started to melt, so it started to leave the sediments also. So by this process, the rock which are made, it is known as trilite. Now for trilite also, like we got the proof, like trilites, same kind of trilites are found in Africa, Falkland Island, Madagascar, Antarctica and Australia, and even in India. So it is also another proof, like all of the continents were together at the beginning. Next we have glacier deposits. So glacier deposits means like we know normally like okay, glacier deposit means it's the accumulation or group or gathering of all the valuable minerals. Okay, so normally we know the gold is found in rocks, but here in Brazil it is found in glacier deposits. Okay, so and in same way it is found here in this coast, Ghana. This is also found in glacier deposits. So it is another proof, like these form together at the beginning. Now last one we have distribution of fossils. Like there was a small creature lemur, which is like believed that it was originated in Madagascar. The fossils of lemur was found in India, Madagascar, and even in Africa too. So since the creature was too small, it was not possible for the creature to move to all the areas. So it is also the next proof, like since all the land masses were together, that's what the fossils are found in different areas. Okay, so whatever we have discussed today, you can check the notes. If you want to make your notes, you can check in description box. Thank you so much.